When we had the Spectre and Meltdown issues, one of the mitigations that came out was some technology that was introduced by Google called Retpoline. And the idea was, in order to eliminate a large class of the indirect branch buffer attacks that Spectre was about, we could take advantage of a compiler-assisted technology to essentially unravel indirect branch targets to take advantage of a form of returns to access indirect calls, which could not be mispredicted by the branch prediction buffer. And this is essentially the technology called Retpoline. And it's contingent on the ability to rebuild all of the code in this manner, because any non-instrumented location or non-Retpoline location would still be subject to an attack. In the Windows environment, initially we relied exclusively on microcode and some expensive instructions to flush the buffers, which had a detrimental performance impact, because in the Windows environment, we generally can't rely on recompilation of all the code outside the OS, because there's a lot of third-party drivers and other components. However, starting in the recent release of Redstone 5 and later, we've introduced a new technology called Hybrid Retpoline, where we essentially combine the best of both solutions, where we rebuilt most of the operating system to use a form of Retpoline, and only when we transition from non-instrumented code to instrumented code to non-instrumented code, we would actually issue the expensive instructions. So in many cases where the code along the path is fully recompiled, you pay almost no penalty. It's comparable to the Retpoline solution you read about before. And this has been a huge performance improvement over the initial set of Spectre mitigations we released.